As you may know, ThinkSol has many different arrow types built into the software. And when you first start using ThinkSol, it's really easy to get confused and not know which arrows are appropriate for which situation. So in this video, we'll cover all the different arrow types in ThinkSol. This includes difference arrows, both level and total difference arrows, and CAGR arrows, both series and total CAGR arrows. By the end of the video, you'll know exactly which arrow type to use in which situation. Let's get started. Total difference arrows compare the totals in a category or time period with the totals in a different category or time period. The important thing to know is that they only compare two different things. They don't take into account three or more. To add a total difference arrow in ThinkSol, select your chart, right click, and there's a button that says add total difference arrow. Click that, and ThinkSol will automatically add the total difference arrow to the chart. If you want to change the periods or the categories that ThinkSol is comparing, click on the arrow and you can drag the anchor to a different point. So as you can see in this chart, the difference between year two and year three is 50%. You can actually add multiple total difference arrows to one chart, and that can be useful, but it's important to realize that this is only used if you want to compare the growth from year one to year two with the growth from year two to year three. This doesn't tell you anything about the growth from year one to year three. You can't just say between year one and year three, we grew by 94%, because the difference between one and three isn't 94%. And that's because of the effect of compounding. So be careful when you compare or you try and sum up multiple different arrows. If you want to compare year one and year three, the best way to do it is either to compare the difference like we are here, or later I'll show you how to use a CAGR arrow. So for now, just remember, total difference arrows are used to compare two time periods or categories. Now let's look at level difference arrows. Now level difference arrows don't compare the totals, so they're not comparing 22 with 31 with 46. They compare a segment of the total. So we might want to compare 13 with 22 with 35. To add a level difference arrow in ThinkSol, again, select the chart, right click, and there's an icon that says add level difference arrow. Click that, and you'll see that ThinkSol has automatically added a level difference arrow. Now, in our example, let's compare sales income between year one and year two. So just like before, drag the anchor to the appropriate part of the chart. There we go. And you can see the difference between 13 and 22 is 69%. Now, it looks a little strange at the moment because the 69% is way on the right of the chart. What we can do is move that and simply click on the arrow and drag it to the place where you think it's most appropriate. For me, I think it's most appropriate between year one and year two. Just like before, you can add multiple level difference arrows to the same chart, and you do that by clicking on the same icons as you did before, and I'll just format it the same. So here you can see the difference between year one and year two's sales income is 69%, and the difference between years two and three sales income is 61%. Now, this is particularly useful if you want to highlight a particular segment or part of a chart. One additional tip I would say is that if we are only interested in sales income, we might want to consider changing the color of the other two segments to be less obvious or less prominent. So I'll just change the fill color to light gray. And here it's a little bit more obvious that we're just looking at sales income and not looking at the rest of the chart. So to sum up, level difference arrows are very similar to total difference arrows insofar as they just compare two time periods or two categories. Now let's look at total CAGR arrows. If you don't know what CAGR stands for, it stands for compounding annual growth rate. And what it does is it takes the value in the first year and takes the value in the final year and calculates the annual growth rate required to get from the first number to the last number. Adding a CAGR arrow in ThinkSol is very easy. Just like the other arrows, select a chart, right click, and there'll be a button here that says add compound growth arrow. Click that. And here you can see it says 47% CAGR. So as I said before, what that means is to go from 22 million in year one to 46 million in year three, it has grown at 47% per year. The great thing about ThinkCell is that it automatically calculates the CAGR based on the underlying data. So it knows that there are 3 years, it knows the starting point and it knows the ending point, and it does the math itself. So the important thing is to make sure your underlying data is all correct so that the calculation that ThinkCell makes is also correct. Finally, let's look at series CAGRs. Now, this is not an arrow as such, but it's a similar concept, so it's worth going through. We just looked at total CAGR arrows, and that told us the annual growth rate required to get from 22 million to 46 million. What if we were interested in the CAGR to get from 13 to 35 million, or from 5 million to 7 million, or even from 4 million to 4 million? We can also do that in ThinkCell. And it's not an arrow, as I said before, but what you can do is click on the series labels, then press Control A, and where it says series, press the drop down button and go series CAGR. And what that's done is it's automatically calculated the CAGR for each of the series. So we know that the total CAGR is 47%, but the individual segments range from 8% to 65%. This is very useful, but it's not visually immediately clear what we're looking at. So my recommendation when using series CAGRs is to format them very similarly to the total CAGR arrow. And I'll do this very quickly and show you what I mean. Okay, I've updated the formatting such that it's clear that the 8, 19, and 65 are CAGRs. Generally speaking, CAGRs sit inside an oval shape, and I've also set the fill color of the oval shapes to match the fill color of the series on the chart. I've also added a title that says CAGR, so it's 100% clear. Generally speaking, this is how I would format CAGRs in a series. So that's it. That is how you use different arrow types in ThinkCell. So now you should know exactly which arrow type to use in every situation. If you have any questions, please drop them down in the comments below and I'll answer them straight away.